Good morning, Fords, and welcome to Age Vision. My name is Connor Salveson.
And I'm Mara Cleary. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We will now move to Jean for today's segment of Jean the Weather Machine.
Hi, it's Jean the Weather Machine. Bundle up today because it's only a high of 67 with a low of 39. But don't worry because it's a bright and beautiful sunny day out. Have a thrilling Thursday, Fords.
Tonight is winter sports night in the auditorium for all winter athletes and parents.
It's time for the annual Thanksgiving food drive. Please bring food donations into your homeroom now through November 7th. Please see the flyer in your homeroom for approved food items.
The sophomores defeated the freshmen in the Model T football game last night. Congrats, Fords.
Another big congratulations to the robotics team who won Ramp Riot 2022 last weekend.
If you're interested in joining the bowling club, stop by room 115 for club information and a permission slip. Slips and money are due this Friday.
The Cash for a Cause fundraiser benefiting Team Haverford and the Eagles Autism Foundation has started. The class with the most money will win a Krispy Kreme.
The Filmmakers Club will be having a meeting after school today in the library.
Our first feature today is a media review of Taylor Swift's new album, Midnights.
Hi, I'm Jean Park.
And I'm Reese Wagner.
And today we're going to be reviewing Taylor Swift's newest album, Midnight.
Taylor released 13 songs at midnight of October 21st and 7 songs later at 3 a.m.
We're going to be reviewing Lavender Haze, Anti-Hero, Bejeweled, and Dear Reader. This is her first song on the album, and I think this was a really interesting choice, but it was also a good choice, I would say. I would give musicality an 8 out of 10, lyrics 10 out of 10.
I think it gives the listener kind of a taste of like what's to come in the next few songs, and I think it's really unique based on some of her other albums that I've listened to. Musicality, I'd give it like a 9 out of 10. Lyricality, I love the lyrics, I'd also give it a 9 out of 10.
The next song is called Anti-Hero. I think it's a lot of reflection on herself, and it's kind of a conversation she has within herself. Musicality, 10 out of 10, going so viral right now. Lyricality, 10 out of 10, and also the music video, 10 out of 10.
I love the way that the music video kind of expresses and tells the story that Taylor's trying to say. I think it's very relatable. 10 out of 10 for lyricality, 10 out of 10 for musicality.
The next song is called Vigil. Baby love, I think I've been a little too. Musicality, 10 out of 10. Everything is a 10 out of 10 for me.
I definitely loved the music video. 10 out of 10 on that. I would say for lyricality, I'd give it a 9 out of 10. Not my favorite, but I thought it was brilliantly written. Musicality, I'd give it probably an 8.
The last song we're going to review is called Dear Reader. And out of her entire album, this is her last song. Dear Reader. I think as like the last song is like the entire wrap up, I loved it. I think there's a really vivid connection between like Lavender Haze and Dear Reader, which I like love. Lyricality, this was a 10 out of 10. Musicality, 9 out of 10.
A lot of the times, at least for me, when I'm listening to songs, it's like I'm singing along with the artist, but this one it's kind of putting you in a different position, kind of seeing her singing it more than with yourself. Lyricality, I'd give it an 8 out of 10. Musicality, 10 out of 10.
But my favorite album before this album came out was definitely Red. Fun fact, re-recorded Red came out on my birthday. but right now, like, Midnights is at number one right now. Like, they are competing for the number one spot.
Out of Taylor's albums, this one is the one that I'm currently listening to the most. I definitely love the new style that she's used, and I can't wait to hear more.
I definitely recommend this album. If you have not listened to any of Taylor Swift's album, which don't know what you're doing, but I definitely recommend you listen to this one. I think it has a song for everybody.
Yeah, I definitely recommend it to anyone who's looking for some great music. Just 'cause they
asked you. It's such a good album. I think the best song is definitely Labyrinth. Our next feature is an on-the-spot about favorite musical decades.
I'm Jacqueline Arazi.
I'm Felicia D'Amico.
And today we're doing On The Spot.
What is your favorite decade of music?
Oh, the 70s, of course. I love disco and the dancing.
The 80s. Favorite decade of music, very easy, the 1980s.
I think it has to unfortunately be the early 2000s, which probably is one of the worst decades of music, but I was in high school and I remember that pretty fondly.
I love the 70s, some 80s, and then a chunk of the 90s.
The 1980s.
Oh, I'm a big fan of the 70s. That would probably be my answer for the best decade, although since you guys did the 90s the other day, I've been going back to that as well.
Right now is my favorite decade of music. I just like all the new songs that are coming out.
Yeah, me too. I like right now.
My favorite decade of music is the 2000s.
The 2000s. Oh, that's good call, but I'm going to go the 90s. Definitely 90s.
The 90s.
My favorite decade of music is the 90s because my favorite band is Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Hey guys, I'm Mr. Weinstock. My favorite decade for music would have to be the 80s. Such an amazing time and so many amazing bands and groups.
My favorite genre of music is right now. I think there's a lot of different types going on.
My favorite decade is probably music in this decade.
Like the 2010s, like that era, you know, like Beauty and the Beat, Justin Bieber.
That's the 90s, baby. I love all that 90s rock because the bands were writing their own songs. You know, bands writing songs. Can you imagine that?
Thank you for watching
On the Spot.
My favorite musical decade has to be the 1990s. Our final feature is a movie review on Knives Out.
With a new Knives Out sequel coming out this month, we ought to look back at the first and review it.
Knives Out is a murder mystery released in 2019. It tells the story of the Thrombey family as they deal with the aftermath of their father, Harlan Thrombey's death. Harlan is an acclaimed mystery novel author with a large estate.
Our protagonist, Marta, is Harlan's aide who takes care of him day to day. Not only that, she is also his close friend and confidant. One night during a family party, a loud noise is heard from the family. The next morning, Harlan is found dead in his room.
Thinking they will inherit Harlan's estate, his family is not hurt by the death at all. But things take a turn when it is all given to Marta. The family immediately turns on Marta and begins to blame her for the killing. Let's talk about soundtrack. The soundtrack uses a lot of string instruments to add a sense of tension and mystery.
I love the soundtrack. That actually makes it like, it enhances it with the whole gothic mansion look. Like, it just kind of adds to the atmosphere that's already built up. Let's talk about the script and dialogue. The dialogue was obviously very accusatory because they're all sitting around in this room, like, mentioning, like, trying to accuse each other of killing their father. So it's blatantly, like, there's a lot of, like, whodunits, this, that.
Yeah, I like a lot of the arguing scenes because the way that all the dialogue's like over each other, it's kind of a lot of things going on at once, and it makes it feel really like natural.
It's like Thanksgiving. This movie is a roller coaster which will keep you on your toes the whole time. The star-studded cast with the likes of Chris Evans, Ana de Armas, Jamie Lee Curtis, Daniel Craig, and more make this a masterclass of acting.
Rian Johnson also does an amazing job directing the film. The cinematography adds a sense of distraction so you never know who the killer is. There's one scene in particular in the first act where Marta is trying to escape the family's questioning, and Johnson uses a handheld shot to show how there are a million things running through Marta's mind.
I like the movie. I would give it an 8 out of 10 and recommend it to anyone in need of a good movie to watch.
I also love this movie and would definitely say it's one of my favorites. The actors and the directing just make it an all-time classic. This is always the first movie I give out as a recommendation. I give this movie a 9 out of 10.
We're both excited to see Knives Out 2 Glass Onion when it comes to theaters this November.
I've never seen it, but it looks really good.
Well, that's it for today, Fords.
Have a great day.
That was a mess.
We come to this club for magic. We come to Filmmakers Club to laugh, to cry, to care.
Because we need that. That indescribable feeling when the interest meeting begins and we go somewhere we've never gone before.
Not just entertained, but reborn together. Learning how to make dazzling images and put them on the silver screen.
Plus, you said I can. Is it even that big of a deal?
creating sound that you can just feel. Somehow, heartbreak feels good here. Our heroes are the best part of us.
When we create together, our stories become perfect and powerful.
Because here,
they are.
Haverford Filmmakers Club. Join today.